So welcome to my All About Code session, which is about installing Xbase++, the Xbase++ product. First thing we need to do this is we need an Xbase++ installation package that you might have received with the postal service and that you can also download from our homepage. And this is I want to show now how to download the package from our homepage. We start a web browser and we navigate to www.alaskasoftware.com. I like first change the language to English here with my settings here. And having done this, I can continue with the login. And if you have no credentials yet, or if you haven't have forgotten your credentials, or you have not even created an account yet with Alaska Software, then you can do this here on this page below with these two items here. If you're not a user yet, you can create an account. If you want to reset your password, you can do it with the second link over here. I have my password, and so I can continue with the login step. You're welcomed with it. Welcome with a home screen, where you also have an item here, the download sender. You have to wait a couple of seconds so that the browser is populating. And then you can already see that there are a bunch of Xbase++ 2.0 versions available to me. It is a professional edition, a foundation edition. It is the English and the German language. I opt for the English professional, which in this case is build 7.6.9, and I click on the download link, and this is it. Now the package gets installed to my computer. Well, to shorten things, I have already prepared this step. I have put the zip file I've downloaded to the desktop. The first thing you might need to do now is to open the properties dialog. And just on the general tab, just check the unblock item here so that the Windows operating system is somehow comfortable with the zip file and its contents. And having done this, you can open the zip file. You can copy and paste the MSI file to the desktop. And here we are. Having done this, I can install the MSI installation package. I zone say next, I click on the next button two times, and then I need to accept the terms of the license agreement after, of course, I have carefully read through the license agreement. I say next, and here we are. The most important part here for the installation procedure is the custom setup dialog. Well, there are a bunch of items you can select and deselect. First of all, you have the workbench, which is the integrated developer and development environment for the Xbase++ command line tools and other tools. And of course, you have below, you have the documentation that you always install, of course. By default, the ActiveX redistributables are deselected, because we don't want to destabilize your system when you already have common controls installed in your system. And here we are. The three items are left now, which is first the Xbase++ 2.0 for Windows, which is nothing else than the command line tools such as compiler, linker, and other things. Everything you need to create desktop applications with Xbase++. And here as sub-items, you also find the source files and the samples, the Xbase++ desktop samples. And very important also this change environment setting here, the feature change environment. Well, I show what this means, what this setting means at the end of the presentation, because this is important to do a site, so-called site-by-site installation, so you can run Xbase++ 1.9 and earlier versions together with the Xbase Plus Plus 2.0. Well, the second thing is you can install the WAA, the Alaska Software Web Application Adapter, which also comes, now it is here, the WAA is here, the other item here, which also comes with some sample packages. And of course, you can install the CXP infrastructure, which also comes with a bunch of samples. Well, for the WAA and the CXP, I plan to do other presentations here in the All About Code section, where I discuss in more detail both amazing technologies. So, well, actually, we have not done anything to the default settings, so we can continue the installation procedure. We have to confirm the user account dialog here, and the installation starts. Well, after the end, we will realize when the installation is finished, we will realize that at a very last step, the workbench is popping up, is started from the installation packets. In strict sense, the first startup of the workbench is finishing the installation procedure. Here is the place, here's the stage where the initial settings are done by the workbench. So, for example, the file associations are done now. And after finishing the workbench at this step, then you're done. The installation, Xbase Plus Plus installation has successfully completed. So, what has the work? What has the installation done to your machine? We can start the workbench from the start menu. And first thing I like to show is to verify the installation. This is something I always do. I go to the help menu. I fire up the desktop samples, an explorer that shows the desktop samples. And I open the apps folder and the MDI folder. And then I load the MDI demo project into the workbench with a double click. And when I select in the build menu, I select rebuild project. And if this is done, and if the MDI demo application is coming up, then a lot of things have been properly installed and are available to your system now. This the compiler, the linker, the resource compiler, and other stuff. So this is quite a good test to verify if an installation has been completed. Well, other thing we can verify is the web samples, the CXP samples. We see that the CXP samples got installed to the IIS root directory, which means that the installer was able to identify an existing IIS 7 installation. So it placed the samples to the www root location. And we can verify whether the CXP infrastructure is properly running, open up a web browser, navigate to localhost, and then cxpinfo.cxp. And if this page is returning a proper result, then also the CXP infrastructure has got properly installed. Last thing I like to verify is the proper installation of the web application adapter. This can be done from the documents folder Xbase Plus Plus, and here got the WAA folder installed where the batch file to start the server is also installed. And if the workbench, if the WAA comes up, then a bunch of packages could be loaded, and so we are done in this aspect also. So actually, we are done now. We have installed Xbase Plus Plus 2.0. So the last thing I've promised to show at the end, what means to do a side-by-side installation. Well, we have installed Xbase Plus Plus on this machine. When we verify the version of our installation, that it tells us it is 2.0.7.6.9. And well, let's change this. Let's take care that the environment is not hampered anymore by the Xbase Plus 2.0 installation. For this, we again start the installation package. We click on the modify button, and then we just deinstall the change environment feature. And after this is done, we will realize that when we again start a command shell and verify the Xbase Plus version from this command shell, then Xbase Plus 2.0 is no longer found because the environment just does not point to it anymore. So at this stage, when you start the Xbase Plus installation package and you disable the environment change setting in the installer, then you just can continue to work with your older Xbase Plus 1.9 or other older versions. So your environment, your computer, your daily work will not be hampered if you don't like to. So, but the clue is, when you start the workbench, when you do 2.0 stuff, which can be done from the workbench, then you will realize you can open the command shell from this tool menu item here. Then you verify the version, Xbase Plus version from here. Then you realize that it is 2.0. So everything that is started from in the workbench is 2.0 now, and everything that is started outside the workbench is 1.9. This is what we call is a side-by-side installation. You have a development machine working with which you are doing your daily projects, and you can try out the 2.0 installation without hampering your daily work in any kind. So if you have questions on this, please contact us. I hope you like this session. I hope you will come back to this channel when I talk about CXP, WAA and other exciting stuff. And goodbye.